praise the name of the Lord. We want to thank God once more for an opportunity to come and share in His Word. I want to thank God for this Father that you've come. I want to hope and be sure that God has kept you well. My name is Gitonga Samuel and I'm born again. I want to give a short reflection about watching over each other. Basically, in this week, we are looking at fellowship and the power of fellowship. And I want to believe that, you know, we all appreciate that we have been living in days where fellowship right now is such a rare opportunity that we are not able to meet together as we ought to be. And as it may be, we find people going through challenges, and since they have no one to share with, then it becomes a big problem. But we must appreciate that we are in times where we must do things differently, and where we have to appreciate that fellowship might have to be more of an online kind of an engagement as opposed to physical engagement. And so it is then important that we just remind each other why it is important and how we will go into fellowship with one another. Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I want to thank you for an opportunity that we have today to even reflect on your word. I want to thank you, Lord, that you have given us this chance even to remember the power of fellowship. So bless us and be with us even as we continue even fellowshipping together through this sharing. In Jesus' name, amen. And yes, indeed, as I have indicated, it is not, we are not on the usual kind of setup of fellowship. We want to appreciate that amongst the five pillars of Christian faith, one of the most fundamental principles of faith or of Christian foundation is fellowship. And hence, we must appreciate that will not have to go or cannot go away or cannot be wished away even when we are talking about a situation that we have right now. And I was looking at the book of Hebrews chapter 10 that we always refer to when we come to learn about fellowship. And I have a few thoughts that I want to share. So Hebrews 10 from verse 24 to 26, the Bible says, "And let us consider how to spur one another to love and to good deeds. Let us not neglect meeting together, as some have made a habit, but let us encourage one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. If we deliberately go to sinning after we have received the knowledge of the truth, no further sacrifice for sins remains." Wow. So, straight to it. The Bible encourages us to consider, to spur one another to two things, love and good deeds. So let's dwell on those three. First, we are asked, even in situations such as these, to consider how to spur one another. And the thought around this statement calls upon us, you know, to consider. Let's be creative enough. Let's see how things are going to work out, so that we can spur each other. And at a time like this, we are finding ourselves, like I've indicated, with a challenge of having the power of fellowship with each other. So how do we get to one another? How do we spur one another to learn under the circumstances of COVID-19? Regulations. How do we do good deeds as situations like this? Are we going to ignore all that? We can't. And that's why I call upon us that we must embrace that we are in a different situation. One of the challenges that we are having, even from a pastoral perspective, is how do we engage one-on-one with people? How do we do counseling? How do we preach to people? You know, all these are challenges that we have to actually begin to think out of the box. And yes, indeed, the Bible doesn't give us space of not meeting. And it says, let us not neglect meeting together. Now, we are likely to find ourselves in many excuses of neglecting fellowship. I thank God because many of us have possibly been fellowshipping through Zoom meetings, through online ministry, through YouTube and all that. We have been caught because the things are different completely. We are not likely to get back to the normal way of handling church, meeting people. We got to remember that in all these situations, we must not neglect meeting to one another. And so I appeal to us today that one, we must ensure that we are in a setup of a grouping that is growing us spiritually. We must either be on a Bible study, a prayer meeting, a district fellowship, you know, a grouping kind of a thing for us to survive in these times. Anybody who is not in fellowship right now is likely to get drawn out all the gains that they have ever made spiritually. And let us remember it is a pillar, which is a key pillar of the foundation that is needed for anybody to grow. And the Bible here says some have made a habit. Please don't form a habit of not meeting. There is no time, there are no gaps, there are no spiritual gaps. Don't create those gaps. Don't say there is no church, so I'm not going to actually be growing. Don't say that I'm creating your own gap in the name of this. You'll not be excused. We got to ensure that this situation that we have at hand, whether we will be meeting online or otherwise, we must have the goal not to neglect that habit of meeting each other. But we are told, let us encourage one another. And this is a message I bring to encourage you today. As we meet today online, as I meet with you today, as you watch this and as you listen and as you get this inspiration, I want to encourage you that you have a reason to consider many avenues of getting to grow spiritually. This Sunday, we hope we will actually have a fellowship. We may not have, we will have a district fellowship right on Zoom. We are not, we may miss one part. One of the part that we are missing most is the swallowship part of it. But you know, the fellowship has to continue as we get, through the leadership, as we get to unite you with other people. Don't just read that message and say, it's other people attending. If you do that, that will only be risking your own spiritual life. And if you risk that spiritual life, then it means that you will be in danger. And then we say, because the day of the Lord, see that the day of the Lord is approaching. You know, as we encourage one another, I want to remind us, remember the coming of Christ is not delayed by COVID. God is not going to push the days when he will be coming back because COVID came. No, there is no postponement of ministry. There is no postponement of coming of God. Christ's coming is not subject to COVID coming or going. We must be ready. We must continue preparing our lives. Let us remember, as we hide in those cocoons of social media, we must not be in sin wherever we are. Let us be reminded that we are actually in readiness to the coming of Christ. Don't sit there saying that, you know, I'll wait until church is back so that I can give my life to Christ, so that I can repent my sins. It's an ongoing process. And that's why finally 26 says, if we deliberately go to sinning, on sinning, yeah, deliberately go on sinning, after we have received knowledge of this truth, then God, the Bible says that no further sacrifice of sin remains. The sacrifice was done at the cross of Jesus Christ. And that was all. That's all. So I want to encourage us that we must deliberately be in a fellowship and be in a gathering that is growing us. Let us not be people who are holding and just saying things are at a standstill. Brothers and sisters, things are moving. We are not in a standstill. Life is moving on. Years are moving on. Don't sit there and say there is a wasted year. We shall not repeat like the kids who repeat a whole year. We are not going to repeat a spiritual year. We are not going to repeat it. It's going, it's moving. We are moving. We are on the move. We are going. Let's get into a fellowship, let's grow, let's consult. And I want to encourage you today through this message. I want you to look for a few people that you can reach out to. Would you want to get, maybe find out how is Gitonga doing? How is so-and-so doing? Call them. The virus doesn't go through your phone, you know? doesn't go through social media, thank God. So please, would you want to get people who are, you know, reach out? We are looking, reconsidering our ministry of evangelism. Reach out to somebody. Just text them. And I want to thank God because I believe through that, you're going to help someone not lose sight of the doing of God. So may the Lord bless you and keep watch over you. I pray through this situation that you're going to appreciate that fellowship is powerful. As we launch the fellowships that are happening even this week, through this week of fellowships, kindly go ahead and join in. Don't be left behind, for we are not postponing the ministry. We are not postponing any spiritual year. We are moving on, and we are on the move. Don't be left behind. Join a group, and the Lord will bless you. God be with you as we even end this week, as we continue the week, and watch over you. May you continue enjoying the blessings and the shadow that comes from the Almighty God. The Lord bless you. Let us pray. I thank you, Lord, for your blessings. Thank you, Lord, that you are reminding us the power of fellowship. I pray that God shall continue happening and continue to fellowship with each other. As we say, telling us you are not postponing the spiritual year, yet we want to grow stronger. And as we are in the move, as we prepare for your coming, we will not get late. Be with us in blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you and see you then.